Alright, are you ready?
If you want the satisfaction,
what do you got?
And working with your hands,
are there yummies in there?
Kaplan College could provide you the education you need to position yourself as a candidate in this important field. At Kaplan,
you get one?
You can receive hands-on training in our labs, which could help you pursue a promising new career. You're good at fixing things. Now turn your talent into what could be a rewarding and paying career with the electrical technician program at Kaplan College.
For a brochure, call 888-791-4949. Summerall versus Summerall Gray and Gray. She made her sister borrow her car and claims her sister's ex vandalized the engine. She wants
her
to cover the damages.
You get it? You want us to get it?
I woke up in the morning at 5:20. My phone was broke. She told me she broke my phone. We got into a verbal argument. And she left. Then I left. I went to a friend's house. And later on at night, I went by my aunt's house to see if I could stay the night there because I wasn't staying at my house. My aunt met me outside and told me that I couldn't come in because
is it too tight?
My wife was already in there and that I couldn't come in there. So I left there. Went to a friend of mine's house, stayed the night. When I woke up, everybody was telling me that I had destroyed this car right that you had with spring right there.
Yeah, let me get it.
Woody, thank you for being with us. Did you perform a polygraph in connection with this case?
I did, Nancy.
On whom?
On Isaac Gray. And one thing I will say, Nancy, if you're going to take a polygraph exam and you're speaking to the examiner and you tell them, well, yes, I've done this in the past, it's probably not the wisest thing to say. We call that a clue.
What were the questions you asked Isaac?
All right, ready?
Did you damage that car? Did you pour water in that gas tank? Did you help anyone damage that car? I administered the test to him.
You get one? I'm gonna move it around.
You confess that you've done this.
Move it around.
And you smile.
I was taking the polygraph test.
You're cheating.
I had before.
No, that's not my point. You're confessing, you're admitting that you have vandalized cars in the past, and you're standing there smiling about it. What else happened, Trip?
Did you get one?
The two most significant questions, which was very interesting in this case. Do you know for sure who damaged that car? And did you help anyone damage that car? That's what brought him to the failure point.
So those are the two questions he flunked the worst.
The worst.
Ma'am, both of your sisters have had the cars attacked. And you're still flunking.
There's another one.
Polygraph.
I didn't see
you got that. It.
They flunked the polygraph. He lied.
Now we're here. And he's saying that he flunked the polygraph.
Yeah.
But beforehand, we weren't.
Well, now you know.
No, I didn't know.
So, you are living with a guy that would do that to your sister's car. To you. He knew you were going to drive the car the next morning. And to your children. He knew you were going to have to take them places.
That's my husband.
To bring it back over here.
I'm praying for him.
You're praying for what?
That we can make it through this.
You think he's going to change?
Yeah.
Couples fight, but they don't tear up your car to the tune of nearly $5,000. They don't physically threaten you. There's not holes in the walls. There's